Zealand, we're roughly projecting 3% growth. Our unemployment's at 3.9% on traditional measures, budget surpluses. People would look at us and go, you're doing okay. But we have homelessness at staggering rates. One of the highest rates of youth suicide in the OECD. Our mental health and wellbeing is not what it should be. So our plan is through the wellbeing work that we're doing, a living standards framework, and our wellbeing budget, where if you're a minister, you want to spend money, you have to prove that you are going to improve intergenerational wellbeing. We are hoping to embed in actually what the public is asking us for, to address the societal wellbeing of our nation, not just our economic wellbeing. I think the importance of addressing this gap that we have in measuring success and broadening out what success is actually gets to the heart of politics and our political crisis. Now, if you are a person sitting at home and post the GFC, hear a politician stand up and say, well, according to what's happening to GDP, we are now in recovery phase, which many politicians did at various points in the cycle, and yet you're sitting there saying, I don't feel that, my situation is not improving, then that means that you have a disconnect and you have that increase in that lack of trust in your institutions and your democracy. And I really think that we've got a number in our political environment now of issues that are becoming proxies for a distrust in institutions delivering for people. So what's one way that we can address that issue? Well, one way is to make sure that, well, what gets measured gets done. We start broadening out the things that we hold ourselves to account on. Our people are telling us that politics is not delivering and meeting their expectations. And so this is not woolly, it is critical. This is how we bring meaning and results for the people who vote for us. And it's not ideological either. It doesn't have to be something just progressive governments do. I think it is about finally saying this is how we match expectations and try and build trust back into our institutions again, no matter where we are in the world. And so some of the work we're doing now will reap the benefits in 20 years' time. But if you start looking at a lens of politics through what we like to use, kindness, empathy, well-being, then actually it doesn't matter what happens just in a political cycle. It matters what happens over decades.